So here on page 30, top left-hand chart, you can see unemployment is about 5.2% and it's falling. However, it's falling for the wrong reasons. It's falling because people are leaving the labor force, right? So although unemployment is basically back down just a hair above where we were pre-COVID, if you look at this chart on the top left of page 29, you look at total non-farm payrolls, we are substantially below where we were pre-COVID levels. So there's just the unemployment rate's falling because there's just people who aren't looking for work anymore. So here's where it may be transitory and it may not be transitory. If you look on the top right-hand chart on page 29, what you see is the change in the labor force participation rate between August 2021. So it's kind of like the latest, the latest data we have. Maybe September's come up, but it's essentially the latest data we have. And where labor force participation was in April 2020, when America shut everything down, told people, hey, COVID, just go home, right? So what you've seen here, and so I break it down by sex, women and men. Women is red, women is red, men is blue, and I break it down by age. So what you're seeing is on the far right, people aged 55 or over, they've just left the labor force, either because, you know, we've had stock prices go to the moon, so their retirement accounts are full. You know, they don't really want to go back to work, they don't want to commute, or for whatever reasons, they're leaving. Now, this in and of itself could be disinflationary because you're going to be replacing these older, more experienced, more higher paid workers with younger, less experienced, lower paid workers. However, what you're seeing, and you know, this has been reinforced by some recent BLS data, is kind of people of peak child rearing age, so men and women, but particularly women, they have been much slower to return to the labor force than other cohorts of the population. And so one of the reasons for this could be the fact that particularly for women who tend to have the bulk of, you know, child rearing responsibilities, if you can't vaccinate your kids and you're worried about your kids getting COVID, and not because, you know, they might necessarily, you know, get sick and die, but because they might pass that on to more vulnerable people, like, for example, your parents or grandparents, that's an issue. Schools have not fully reopened. Daycares have not fully reopened. So for a variety of these reasons, or at least my hypothesis, is that you're seeing women have been slower to return to the labor market. Now, when you ask yourself, you know, where have the labor shortages been most acute in the US economy? Leisure and hospitality, it tends to be those sectors and industries where, you know, that are dominated typically by lower income female workers age 35 to 44. So this is a key chart that I'm watching to see if the labor force participation rate picks up. If it does, and you start getting a decrease in unemployment, at the same time you get stronger labor force participation and employment levels are rising, then I think you're looking at a more growthy outlook. So there'll still be inflation, but there'll be growth, there'll be productivity gains, wage costs will start to slow below productivity gains, and we're kind of in this a pretty good Goldilocks scenario. However, if you don't see labor force participation rate pick up, then the labor shortages become more acute. They exacerbate the other inflationary pressures that we're seeing, China, supply chains, commodity prices, etc. And then it's a more stagflationary outlook.